until you see his face. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. If you want to see him, we got to do what we got to do. We got to do what we have to do. If you want to run this race, we got to do what we have to do. We got to look unto the Lord God Almighty. Lift your eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh your help? Your help has come from the Lord. Bless the Lord. I praise God for his word today. We're going to get into his word right now. And I thank God for what he's about to do in this place. I can feel that he's already going to bless someone in a mighty, marvelous way. And this week, you're going to experience a supernatural blessing. Trust and believe in these words. Trust and believe in these words, dear sister and dear brother. You trust and believe it. I have been praying about a lot of things over the past few weeks. And I tell you today, in the name of Jesus, that everything I have prayed for, I have received within 2 weeks' time. I'm telling you, when you pray for one in here, you pray. You really, really pray. And you trust in God. You see, trust is the main ingredient behind faith. You got to have faith and you got to trust in God with all your heart and lean it on your own understanding. That's how it works. That's how it works. You want God to work for you? You got to trust and believe in God and he will work for you. He will work for you. He's not going to leave you. He's not going to forsake you. He's with you. Lo, he's with you for all your days. Bless the Lord. Goodness and mercy shall follow you for all the days of your life. And we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord. And our text today is taken from the book of John. The book of John chapter 14 and verse 23. Praise the Lord. Lord Jesus, thank you for this glorious word. I pray that the Holy Spirit would use me right now to bring forth the right message through this word. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I declare and decree, it is done in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Amen. John 14 and chapter 23. Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. Bless the Lord. I'll read it one more time. John 14 and verse 23. Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. So if you love God, won't you keep the words of God? Won't you write them upon your heart and bind them upon your neck in the name of Jesus? Would you not do that? Praise God. Praise God for those that have done that. I am most certain that I've seen a difference in their life. Are you ready to see change in your life take place? Come on now. Write the commandments of God upon your heart and bind them around your neck. Tie it around your neck. You live and you walk. Walk by faith, not by sight. You activate every word of God upon your life. And you will begin to see things taking place in the spiritual realm. Come on now, I'm telling you, in the name of Jesus, it's going to happen. It's going to happen. And my Father will love him. No one goes to the Father but through Jesus Christ, henceforth. If a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him. Jesus Christ, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, all in one. Remember again, I'll repeat myself. No one goes to the Father but through the Son. The Son is Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. He is the only way. He is the truth and the light. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Come on now. Trust in God. I say light as well because he is the light of the world and he is the life. He is everlasting life. You got to understand that in the name of Jesus. And we will come unto him and make our abode with him. We will come to God through the Son of Man, who is Jesus Christ, and make our abode with him in heaven. Heaven is our abode. Abode means our dwelling place, our home. Remember, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. So are you willing to even make down here on earth right now your heavenly home? As for now, we can say that this can be our heavenly home. And I tell you this through the power of the Holy Spirit. You can make your house a house of prayer. You can make your home a home of worship.
You can make your ministry everywhere that you go, no matter what type of ministry you are involved in, if it's charity-based, if it's evangelism, if it's preaching, if it's worship, if it's dance, if it's reading the Word of God, any form of ministry, I'm telling you, you can make it in this life by using what you have, all your talents, all your abilities, all your strength, because your strength comes from the Lord. You can use it all for the honor and glory of God. And I'm telling you, mark my words today in the name of Jesus. I dare you today in the name of Jesus. I dare you today in the name of Jesus. And I'm telling you this because I'm so confident in the Lord. This is God's confidence. I dare you today. This is September month. This is the month of September. And I dare you in the name of Jesus to mark these words. Make your home a place of prayer and a place of worship. And you watch and see by the 30th of September if a miraculous blessing would not fall into your way. Would not fall into your hands. Come on, you're going to tell me, yes, there's a blessing. There's a blessing that came into my life. Now I'm telling you, blessings come in many different forms. All right? A lot of people tend to look at material blessings and financial blessings alone, which is a good blessing. I'm telling you, because poverty is a sin. To be poor in this world and not have is a sin. Remember, God said even, blessed are the poor in spirit. But I want to tell you today, through the power of the Holy Spirit, and this was not even in my message, because I don't plan anything to say. God just leads me, and this is how I love to minister. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for this is the kingdom of heaven. Let me tell you what this means. Remember this. And God is saying this. This is how we link that verse together with those words. God is telling you this. Poor in spirit does not mean that you have nothing, that you are lacking. It doesn't mean that you lack. It doesn't mean that you have to be poor or remain poor in this life, throughout this life, to see God's face. No, that does not happen. And it does not mean that one bit. It does not mean that your pocket got to be empty to be poor in spirit, that you would get into heaven. Come on now. It does not mean that. It does not mean you have to be poor in spirit to reach out to God and connect to God. It doesn't mean anything that you are less humble or you are any less full of yourself. Let me tell you what it means. I want to tell you what it means. To be poor in spirit means that you understand that you can be humble, and at the same time, you are meek. You are meek. You are meek. The meek shall inherit the earth. I'm telling you this. I'm telling you this today. Understand this. This is from the kingdom of God. This is from the throne of grace. God sits on the throne of grace, and he is telling you this. God is saying to be reminded, if you know the God that you serve is a provider and he owns it all, if you understand that, and if you know the truth behind this, you would understand what God has in store for you. You would understand who you are in God. You would stop questioning things of this world. You would understand. You would understand what God put here for you. You would understand what you are made of. You would understand what you are made of. You would understand what you are made of. No one can come around you and say anything about you, because it would mean squashing the end. It would mean absolutely nothing if it comes from someone who is not a man or woman of God. It would not mean a thing to you, because you would know better. You would know better than everyone, sister. You would know better, because you know what the Word of God says about you. He said, Blessed are his children. Blessed are his children. We are a chosen generation. I repeat myself from the last message here in this portion of this word now. We are a chosen generation, a heritage of God. And we are here to do what our Heavenly Father has called us to do, appointed us to do, called us forth to do in such a time as this. And we today, we uphold the mantle of Jesus Christ. We uphold it. Remember, even Moses. Remember what he held. He held a staff. But you know what? Most believe that was the strength of God he was holding. That was the strength of God. Remember when he stretched forth that staff, that Red Sea parted. In the name of Jesus, he stretched it forth into the heavens. And then he stretched it forth out to the Red Sea. So whatever you do, you pray about it from the heavens above, and then you bring it down here to earth, because whatever you ask of God in heaven, he will make it happen here on earth for you. Because as you ask God, remember, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Remember the Lord's Prayer? Come on now, I'm telling you this in the name of Jesus, amen. Remember this in the name of Jesus. Whatever God has in store for you is for you. Don't question yourself. Don't question yourself or your abilities anymore. Don't question yourself. Don't question yourself and say that you are unable or unable to do anything that God says you can do. I'm telling you this today. You ought to please God. If a man, I repeat the verse again, if a man love me, he will keep my words. You keep the words of God. God said that you are blessed and highly favored, then you are blessed and highly favored. If God says he's your rock, he's your rock. If God says he's your strong tower, he's your strong tower. If he says that you're a refuge in a time of storm, he is your refuge in a